The Philippine Poll Body denying claims its 2024 budget includes funding for charter change. A by representative at Selagman earlier flagged the additional 12 billion pesos in one of COMELEC's elections budget items. But COMELEC Chairman George Garcia says that amount is part of the 17 billion pesos they requested to be restored after the amount was slashed from their budget proposal. Despite this, the COMELEC is not denying the possibility the 12 billion pesos can still be used for a plebiscite pushing for Chacha.
Amin din natin pwede po. Pwede po namin gamitin yan. Nasa amin naman po ang discretion bilang isang constitutional body. Pero siyempre po sa kasalukuyan, nakafocus po ang COMELEC sa resumption ng ating registration. Where two, nagko-concentrate kami sa preparasyon para sa national and local election ng 2025. At number three, naghahanda na po kami para sa barangay ng SK elections din ng 2025. There's some to spot at this point yung mga ganyan.
Prime movers of charter change now turning to television advertisement to push their agenda. A paid commercial on the supposed failures of the 1987 Constitution appeared on primetime evening newscasts this week. This drew flack online with some lawmakers and organizations calling the advertisement inaccurate.
Sino ang nagpondo nito? Kung public funds yung advertisement, may problema tayo. Illegal yun eh. Dahil hindi pa natin, you know, use public funds for a private purpose.
Mm-mm.
Katulad ng People's Initiative.
Ang pinalalabas nila, parang ang pagbabago ng konstitusyon ay sagot sa lahat na major problems ng bansa. Ngunit hindi naman ito totoo. No? Pinalalabas din na very urgent ito at ang makikinabang ay yung mga maliliit na tao, no? O yung mga disadvantaged sa lipunan, no?
The paid ad was found to be placed by the law firm called Gana Atienza Avisado Law Offices. The firm serves as the legal counsel of the group Pirma, which sought to amend the charter through a people's initiative. The law firm meanwhile clarifies no public funds were used for the ad.
Purpose ho nitong advertisement na napanood ho ninyo is to bring into public discussion. This is a private initiative. We are a private, a small law office who represents Pirma and other similarly minded individuals na gusto rin pong tumulong at isulong ang public consultation for People's Initiative to amend the Constitution.
A Philippine lawmaker recommends to move the deadline of the implementation of the PUV modernization program. Dan Fernandez made that call as House lawmakers probe alleged corruption in its implementation. For Fernandez, the rescheduling of the deadline will help improve government's modernization program.
I move that we request the president of this country to reschedule the deadline on January 31, considering all the imperative revelation of all the events that we have discussed in this hearing concerning a lot of things for the betterment of the modernization program of the government to make it more effective and to consider the welfare of the Filipino drivers who will be directly affected by this deadline.
Transport regulators, meanwhile, vow to recalibrate the program to ensure that the rights and welfare of drivers and operators will be protected.
Base ko dun sa mga kwentong na narinig po namin, there is a necessity ngayon to recalibrate, re-evaluate po yung proseso ng aming ahensya po together with the Office of the Transport Cooperative who is managing these cooperatives. We will take it second look, we will take a hard look po para po yung mga ganitong mga issues ho ay hindi na po maulit.
Philippine senators seeking the revocation of the franchise of the National Grid Corporation of the Philippines, or NGCP. During Wednesday's Senate probe on the Western Visayas blackout, leaders of affected provinces decried losses incurred from the power outage. At least one mayor expressing intent to take legal action for damages. But the NGCP reiterated it has done its best and followed all the protocols.
We followed the requirements of PGC as na nagmamandate po sa amin na gawin yon. And then we assess the system based nga po sa assessment normal.
That response did not sit well with Senate Energy Committee Chairman Rafi Tulfo.
Dapat natataranta na kayo. Napakadali sa inyo magsalita. Kasi hindi kayo apektado eh. Wala kayo doon sa Iloilo. Madali kayo magsatsat dyan.
The leaders of the Philippines and Indonesia discuss energy and defense cooperation, including rising tensions in the South China Sea. Katrina Domingo has more on the bilateral meeting between President Marcos and his Indonesian counterpart, Joko Widodo.
Indonesian President Joko Widodo's visit in Malacanang sealed the commitment between the Philippines and Indonesia to further bolster their cooperation in the fields of economy, energy, security, and defense.
President Widodo and I had a fruitful and honest discussion on regional events of mutual interest, such as the developments in the South China Sea and ASEAN cooperation and initiatives. The Philippines and Indonesia affirmed our insistence on the universality of UNCLOS, which sets out the legal framework that governs all activities in the oceans and in the seas.
Aside from agreeing to forge more deals on border security and patrol, Widodo also asked for Marcos Jr.'s support in a possible deal to procure anti-submarine warfare aircraft for the Philippine Navy from Indonesia.
I welcome the strengthening of cooperation on border security, including through joint patrols. But there are many things still need to be improved. I also seek Your Excellency's support related to purchase of anti-submarine warfare aircrafts for the Philippine Navy from PT DI Indonesia.
The Armed Forces of the Philippines earlier bought two anti-submarine helicopters from the United Kingdom. AFP officials earlier said the Philippines plans to get four more units, but did not say which suppliers the government is considering. Meanwhile, the Philippines and Indonesia also signed a cooperation agreement that guarantees the two countries would aid the other should there be critical supply constraints in the energy sector. Indonesia is one of the world's largest producers of coal, needed to generate power in coal-fired power plants. The energy deal also includes opportunities for both countries in the fields of energy transition, renewable energy, and alternative fuels. After their bilateral meeting, Malacanang hosted a state banquet for Widodo and his entourage, where officials cheered the upcoming 75th anniversary of formal diplomatic relations between the Philippines and Indonesia. After visiting Malacanang, Widodo traveled to Laguna to check the operations of an Indonesian-owned coffee factory. The president of Southeast Asia's largest economy says his country is ready to further expand their investments in the Philippines.
In order to enhance trade, we agreed to continue to open market access, and Indonesia seeks the Philippines' support related to special safeguard measures on Indonesian coffee products.
Special safeguard duties is a trade mechanism that a country can impose on imported products that fall below a so-called trigger price. The Philippines decided in March this year that it will continue slapping such duties on imported coffee products if the items are below the trigger price to protect local farmers. Bilateral trade between the two countries was pegged at $9.5 billion in 2021. Indonesia has been importing copper wire and other machine parts from the Philippines, while the Philippines has been sourcing coal, palm oil, paper, and other materials from Indonesia. Widodo is scheduled to return to Indonesia on January 11. Katrina Domingo, ABS-CBN News.
The mother of a Filipino death row convict in Indonesia appeals to President Joko Widodo to free her daughter. Mary Jane Veloso had been sentenced to death after she was caught smuggling heroin into Indonesia in 2010. Her mother joined a protest on Wednesday to insist on Mary Jane's innocence.
Nakikiusap po ako sa ating Pangulo na sana ngayon magkakaharap na po sila na ating presidenteng si Marcos at presidente ng Indonesia. Sana hingin na niya yung clemency ni Mary Jane. Sana palayain na po nila. Dahil matagal na po nagdo si anak ko na wala kasalanan.
No mention of Veloso's case in the official statements of Marcos and Widodo, but the Philippine Foreign Affairs Department says Marcos hopes the progression of Veloso's case will grant her clemency at the right time. Veloso was granted a stay of execution pending the result of her trafficking case against her recruiters. Let's now get an update on the weather from PAGASA forecaster Lori De La Cruz. Hi, Lori.
Yes, good morning, ma'am, and to all our viewers and listeners. Northeast monsoon continues to affect the northern and central Luzon, while shear line is now affecting the eastern section of southern Luzon. With this, Bicol region and Quezon province will experience cloudy skies with rains and thunderstorms due to the effect of the shear line. While for Cagayan Valley and Aurora, they will experience cloudy skies with light rains due to Amihan or northeast monsoon. Metro Manila and the rest of Luzon, we will experience isolated light rains due to Amihan or northeast monsoon, while the rest of the country, they will experience generally fair weather apart from localized thunderstorms. Meanwhile, strong to gale force are still expected over the seaboards of northern Luzon, specifically Batanes, Cagayan, including Baboyan Islands, Isabela, and Ilocos Norte. So sea travel is still risky over the mentioned areas. The latest from PAGASA, this is Lori De La Cruz.
Thank you very much for that update, Lori.